There is an ambiguity in the way we use the language of purpose. When we say something like, the purpose of an aeroplane's tail is to stabilize it, we're saying something about the intention of the designer. But a bird's tail does much the same thing. If a bird didn't have a tail, it would pitch and roll like an aeroplane without a tail. So it's natural to use the same kind of language. The purpose of a bird's tail is to stabilize it. The purpose of a hedgehog's spines is to protect it. The purpose of a rabbit's fur is to keep it warm, and so on. But of course, everything about animals and plants that looks as if it's been designed for a purpose has in fact been shaped by the slow sculpting of natural selection. And I'm calling this kind of pseudo-purposiveness archaeopurpose. It's the ancient kind of purpose before the human kind of purpose or the nervous system kind of purpose evolved. It resembles deliberate intentional purpose, but it is not. There is no intention there. The archaeopurpose of a bird's wing is to aid flight, and you see there four beautiful flying machines which in their different ways would excite the admiration of any aerodynamic engineer who might have designed these things. These are man-made flying machines with a neo-purpose. The neo-purpose of a wing in a plane is to aid flight. Neo-purpose, as opposed to archaeo-purpose, is the kind of purpose we are all familiar with from our own designs and schemes and goals. And my thesis tonight is that neo-purpose is itself an evolved adaptation with a survival value or archaeo-purpose, in the same sense as a feather, an eye, a tail, or a backbone has an archaeo-purpose. Brains have evolved with various capacities that assist the survival of the genes that made them. Among these evolved capacities is the ability to set up goals or purposes, and the ability to design machines and other artifacts that resemble naturally evolved organs like tails, wings, eyes, and hearts. And, of course, artifacts that resemble brains themselves, computers.